Welcome and welcome back to the channel. Alright guys, let's get started. Let's jump right into it. We're working on bank one cylinder head. Alright, we're doing valve train. These are the special tools we will be using. Same as we used on bank two. Okay, now let me show you a picture of the crankshaft. That's what you need to use in order to rotate the engine. The reason you need to rotate it is to bring top dead center up. Okay, do not use the camshaft to bring up top dead center. There's the alignment marks we need to match. They need to be facing each other. If you have to grab a mirror, go ahead and grab a mirror to verify that the timing marks are facing each other. Now here's a special lock tool we're going to use. Okay, just put that in its place. All we're trying to do there is lock the cams together so we can remove the oil control valve. Okay, you may have to rock the camshaft with a wrench. That's fine. Now with the cams, with the phasers in time, we need to mark them, okay, in relationship to the timing marks. All right, we want the timing chain marked to the cam phasers. Okay, we will need this information during reassemble. All right, now we got our lock tool in place. What we're gonna do now, man, is grab a socket. What we want to do, or what we need to do, is remove this. Now this is the rocker arm we're going after. I'm in the middle of replacing the rocker arm anyway, so I figure I'll record. Okay, so let's put a wrench right here, just on this hex head. We're not gonna use that to turn, we're just gonna use that to hold. So we can merely take this oil control valve off, okay? This bolt acts as the cam phaser bolt. Ah! And the oil control valve bolt. All right, once we get that off, ladies and gentlemen, you can pretty much remove the cam phasers at this point. You really don't need any special tool to remove the valve train off of. The special tools come into play during reassemble. In fact, I don't use any tools at all, but I refuse to show you how to do this without the tools. Okay, so let's get this cam phaser off. Here's the block tool off. Now let's get the phaser off. And guys, you can just lay that chain down, just leave it laying down. If you don't feel comfortable, grab you a bungee cord to hold it up. But if not, just let it hang. Just let it lay down on the other phaser. Depends on which camshaft you're doing, okay? My problem is in the intake camshaft. Intake cam phasers. Not so much the phaser, the rock arm. I have a ticking noise, okay? What I'm chasing is a broken rocker arm. So let's remove the valve train. All right, here's the camshaft. We got the camshaft off. Now, here is what I suspect is the broken rock arm. Look at that, guys. That is terrible, okay? Remember, guys, those shavings had to go somewhere, so I highly advise you to change the oil when you're done. Okay, guys, I'm working kind of reckless right now. If I was you, I would put a rag over that intake, those intake manifold opening, okay? I'm in a big rush, and I didn't think to do it, but I highly advise you to do it. Also, guys, keep in mind, I advise you to replace the lifter in the particular broken rocker arm. Okay, so whichever rocker arm was broke, I highly recommend you replace the lifter that was holding the rocker arm. Okay, so let's get them all off and check the remaining lifters. All right, so let's install new valve train parts, namely the rocker arms. Okay, these are the ones in question. Okay, I'm just doing the intake side of bank one. Okay, you know, at the dealership where we can only replace what's broken. This is one of my personal cars, so I'm okay. Now let's lubricate this valve train. You do not want to put a camshaft on dry. Okay, normally I will use engine lube assembly, but I am all out, so simple oil will work, guys. All right, let's place the new camshaft in place. Let's lube it up again on the top end, and then we're going to proceed to install the caps. Okay, now these caps have torque rating, okay, so please torque them to spec. Now we're getting ready to install our special tool. This is the tool we will need in order to remove the timing chain guide off of the timing change, which will create a slack in the change, which will allow you to install the cam phasers, okay, with ease. All right, it's just simply making your job easier. Now this bolt right here, guys, this bolt will act as a guide to this tool. All right, now I'm gonna show you a cutaway view. Okay, here's an engine I have cutaway. Okay, I'm just merely showing you this. This is the same tool, guys. They made them plastic at first, and then they went to aluminum. It was just redesigned, but it's the same tool. Okay, all you want to do is install it. Use this bolt right here as a guide. That's what it's there for. That's what the tool is designed to be used for, okay? All we're going to do is guide that down. What we're trying to do is compress or remove the timing chain guide off of the chain. You see what I'm doing? It's just a cutaway view. You can't see this if you're working on a car. I'm just showing you what's going on inside of the engine. All right, now just press down on the tool, and now you have slack in the chain, guys. There is no grenade pin to pull or anything like that. All the tool is doing is compressing the guide off of the chain. All right, now let's do it on the car in real world time, okay? Just let's get this chain out of the way so you can see real good. Don't worry about the chain coming out of time. That will not happen. And besides, you have it marked, so you're just going to put the marks back where you remove them from. Now, there is the guide we're going to put in between the bolt right there. All right, place your tool on that bolt and just guide press it down easily and slightly, okay? No need to bang it down in there. We just want to guide it down enough to remove that guide off of the chain. And there you have it. I felt the detent, okay? So now, guys, it's just a matter of installing the timing chain onto the phasers, okay? I have the exhaust timing chain on, and I have it in place with the marks, okay? So now let's grab the intake cam phaser. All right, now, whether you're replacing this or not is up to you, but this is a good time to replace it if you were replacing it. This is a good time to do the complete valve train system, all right? So now I have this cam phaser in time with the timing chain marks. All right, so now, guys, you may have to grab a wrench just to slightly rotate the camshaft in order for the marks to line up. Okay, we have enough slack. It's not slack we're chasing at this point because we have the tool in place. All right, so what we need now is a wrench just to turn slightly and align the marks up so this cam phaser see, like this, what we're trying to do. All we're trying to do is match up the marks. Eventually, this phaser, there you go. It is now attached to the camshaft. Okay. Now, guys, verify your marks. Make sure your marks are in time as it relate to the cam phasers. And, guys, we almost done, man. All you have to do now is simply install the... we're going to put our block tool back in place because what we're getting ready to do is to torque this oil control valve. There is a torque specs. I will put them in the description, okay? We really needed this tool just to push the guide off of the chain, okay? Some guys use it, some guys don't. I decided to show you the proper way to do it, all right? Now, let's simply torque this bolt down. And, guys, where do we go from here? We're going to torque down the... we need to put this in place first. Remember, do not... you don't want to use the actual camshaft to hold it. So use the proper tools, guys. That's what they're built for. We're going to put this in place, and then we're going to grab our torque wrench. And what we're going to do is simply put our torque wrench in place where it's supposed to be. You know, look at the description that will show the specs. And all we're going to do is torque the bolt down to specs. Remember, do not forget to torque the camshaft caps down to specs also. All right, let's remove the tools, guys. We're pretty much done. This valve train on bank one has been reconditioned, okay? Based on our diagnosis, we found a rocker arm broken in cylinder 5, I think that was, okay? So we merely replaced the broken rocker arm and the lifter in that same rocker arm, and we replaced all the rest of the rocker arms on the intake side, okay? You need to replace whatever you deem necessary, especially since you have the valve train torn apart. That's what we had. This was a good time to install new valve train parts all together if you want to, but this is the proper procedure. All right, so from there, guys, we just need to reassemble the engine. All right, I'm just gonna reverse some engine installation video that I had in the past. So let's put this thing back together, guys, and we're gonna wrap it up. Thanks for watching, comment, subscribe, and I'll see y'all on the next video.